Hey everybody, nice to be back. Today, or yesterday, was International Whiskey Day, and that may explain why I missed it. Went to the doctor early this week and he said to drink more water, so I'm back to the Smirnoff Seltzer. First ingredient is, you guessed it, water. I'm not sure this is exactly what he meant though, so I'll have to think about this. Now, here we are. I went out of the house today and crossed the border into Queens, which is odd for me. It must mean that I really love you. But when I got there, I actually hugged people. I saw people. I talked to people I haven't seen in a year, which was fantastic. Fauci doesn't want that. He wants me in the house. And that is a COVID-spreading party, according to him. Doesn't make a difference. But you know what? It was nice to see everybody. I am a little confused these days because we are over a year of stopping the spread of the corona and really trying to get things in control. But yet I still see people wearing masks in their car. And now I see people riding bikes with masks, jogging with masks, and I'm beginning to think it's a fashion statement because they are matching it to the outfits that they are wearing, which is bizarre. You know what I call these people? I think we have words for it, and I'm sorry you fall into this category. Morons! Enough with the masks when you're outside by yourself. Enough with the masks when you're in the car. You'll look like a dope. So, Joe Biden, our president, gave his first press conference the other day. And it was a interesting press conference. Very interesting. He did say that he expects to run again. And will Kamala Harris be his running mate? He said she's a great partner. Sure, if you ask Willie Brown, he may have a different opinion. But Joe thinks she's a great partner. And if you're lucky enough, no refunds, no returns. Even for two times, when he runs again, gas will be $10 a gallon. So we got that going for us. So he was asked a question about gun control. Now, gun control is very important. There's just another mass shooting, which our media had to be incredibly disappointed. Incredibly disappointed it wasn't by a white guy. They all posted it was by a white guy before it happened. If it was a person of color, he'd be dead. Again, defund the media. So Joe's asked a question, and then he goes on a 10-minute diatribe about the infrastructure. Never answered the question. Perhaps he forgot. Who knows? Same man, our president, walking up the stairs, fell down three times, blamed it on the wind. How strong was that wind to blow a grown man down twice? Down twice, and then the third time, down to one knee. And he just waved them, okay, all right. You know, it'd be funny if somebody screamed, man down, as he was going down. A lot of funny memes of the Air Force chair going up and down. Funny with Joe, because Joe ran on the premise of bringing the soul of the United States back. I'm gonna bring it back. Well, you know what I think he seems like bringing back? Illegal immigrants. He's bringing back illegals at a rate. And if you ask them, they're saying, why are you coming, Joe Biden? And Joe said, they're coming because I'm a good man. Joe, your priorities are a little backwards, Joe. I don't know, maybe you're thinking about make America illegal again, Joe. I prefer the legal America opposed to the illegal America. You got everything backwards, Joe. You got everything backwards. Some may see this and say I'm a racist. That's not the case. But I am learning that everything's racist. Everything is racist. Filibuster, racism, water, racism. Having an ID to vote, racism. Everything is racism. American history, racism. Everything's racism. Want me to tell you what racism is? Out in Oakland, the mayor is starting a fund that's privately funded, not government funded, it's privately funded, where families who make under $57K are getting $500 a month. Bonus, $500, $57K. They need it. But the caveat is actually, it's only available to black families. Sounds a bit racist to me, so let's circle back to this, as our press secretary says, and ask ourselves, are we looking to start a race war? Because that's what it seems like. You want a race war? I don't want a war at all. And I love all races, as should you. You know what I don't love? Bad human beings. And I don't love racists, because they would fall under the category I just named. So let's get over this and stop talking race. Race continues to be perpetuated by the media who hate us. They hate us all. They don't like you. A bit like the government. They're all in it for themselves. Now, back to Kamala Harris. There is a lecture going around on how to empower women. I think that's great. Women should be empowered. Everybody should actually be empowered. However, two of the key speakers are Kamala Harris and Slick Bill Clinton. Very odd choices. Considering the way that Kamala Harris smashed the glass ceiling with Willie Brown, and, I don't know, I never with that woman, Bill Clinton, it just doesn't seem right to me. Now, I wonder if in these lectures they are going to have Willie Brown and Monica with them, especially if she's wearing a nice blue dress. Who would want to see that? Maybe we could relive some memories. Just a bit of history. I'm figuring that's not racist, white on white. Who knows? I'm sure right now. Very odd choices. Very, very odd choices. Now, apparently, the Republican Party is trying to keep the minorities down from voting. So there was a law passed somewhere, I think it was in Georgia, and our president had a comment. And the comment read, "This bill makes it harder for working people and blacks to vote." Working people and blacks. Joe, are you saying that black people don't work? I know black people don't work, plenty of them. Plenty of black people work, Joe. Not the ones who took the jobs away from the pipeline, because there was a big community of black people who did work on that pipeline. They may not be working anymore, Joe. That's on you, black people. Unbelievable, Joe. Ugh. Again, racist. Now, I go into the bookstore the other day for the first time and God only knows how. Walk in, first book I see. The name of the book is Anti-Racist Baby. Anti-Racist Baby. Aren't all babies anti-racist? They basically do just a few things. They pee, they poop, they cry, they sleep. That's it. They don't know their colors. We got somebody teaching them the gay ABCs, which will go with the anti-racist baby. That's probably the sister book that goes along with it. Wait a minute. Can't be the sister book. That is probably the other book. Do not want to label or misgender a book. Very offensive. Very, very offensive. Wouldn't want to do that. But that's not what surprised me the most. There was a table of books about Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Ruth Bader Ginsburg comic books, graphic novels, coloring books, yoga books, cookbooks. Who are buying these books? When did Ruth Bader Ginsburg become her own brand? I did look at the yoga book, though. It's like a cartoon book. It's pretty funny. Ruth Bader with her glasses and all these poses, and she was always wearing that, I don't know what you call it, that white thing she wore around her neck. It was, for the humor value, it was very funny. It was very funny. Really is. The government is, you'll probably be happy to know, they are starting a committee for alternatives to policing. So there will be some alternatives. I know we had a movie about it a few years back called The Purge. Maybe they should watch it, because that really is the alternative. You know, we're doing everything we can to constrain and castrate these police officers. Police officer down in Virginia who wasn't even on a call, he was on patrol, heard some gunshots, came around, saw a guy with a gun who just shot somebody, pulled his gun, the man was of color, and he shot the guy. So now the community wants justice, they want this guy fired because he didn't turn on his body camera. How does that conversation work? Excuse me, shooter, I need 1 second to please turn on my camera so I can make sure I do not violate your civil rights. I'm sure that's it. Perhaps they want him to sign a waiver first. How stupid are we? These cops gotta make a decision in a second. You're not helping anyone, you're only hurting people. So enough of this nonsense. My Twitter ban has lasted a month, but they got back to me and they sent me an email. They would like any other information that would help clarify my comment. So my comment was, when presented with a picture of two women, my comment was, what would you do? I would die lonely. It was actually only die lonely. very innocuous, talking about myself, they took offense. So my response was, have you ever seen HRC and Caitlyn, dead name, Bruce Jenner? You would die lonely also. That was it. I think over Twitter, they had the non-fun company. Everything's politically correct, can't hurt everybody's feelings. They would be very bad at a game of murder, marry, and sleep with. Probably doesn't exist over there, never heard of it. They even see this video when I brought it up, I'd be banned for life. But I think the ban's gonna come back now, or come down now, and whatever it's gonna do, it's not gonna be around much longer. Oh, now, everything's been quiet here at home, but if you have any problems, please post a comment, and my wife can solve them for you. Even if you don't think they're problems, just write down something that's going well. She'll find a problem and fix it. Right now, she fixed this week. We have new spoons. Apparently, our spoons are broken. There's a problem with spoons. I don't know what the problem was, but there was a problem, and now it's not a problem. Now, the squirrels have been well-behaved this week. One of the squirrels the other day was spinning around, chasing his tail, and goes down, boom, bobs his head on the couch, gets up and looks at me and goes, hey, Dad, a spingery. Ain't funny with the one lines, I'll tell you that. Doesn't get that from me. Now, if you are referring to your offspring as an adult child, maybe you're the problem. Just saying, adult child. A little bit of an oxymoron. That really isn't a positive connotation. It's actually very negative. Now, speaking of adult children, my 53-year-old friend, Steve, nobody's seen him. He went silent. Now posted on Facebook. He's not returning calls. Nobody's seen him. He can't call the house because there's only a landline. Nobody knows if it even works. But his mom's so old, she can't hear it. And she certainly can't walk up the stairs to see if he's dead. So we don't know what the update is. If anybody knows about Steve, Stevie, you're out there. Let us know if you're alive. Yeah, people are concerned. We're no longer getting pictures of ducks in the sunset at the park that you were taking. Maybe that's because you're not working. You can't drive anymore. Who knows? But please, reach out. We're concerned, Steve. Adult child. There you go. Not a negative. Not sure. Now, I stumbled upon some highlights, and I used that term very loosely, of the Grammys the other day. And I saw Cardi B and The Stallion performing what was music? It's not music. It's horrible noise. But which was even more concerning were the two names, Cardi B and The Stallion, which I found ironic because Cardi B looks like a stallion. She looks like a horse face. The woman's got so much money from robbing guys after drugging them and this non-music career that maybe she gets a little plastic surgery because makeup's not going to fix it. She needs more than a makeover, man. Horse face. Or maybe she just got hit in the face with a shovel. Not racist. I'm just talking about aesthetics. Oh, now, from the life coach, Angry Mac. The life coach, some questions answered. One of the questions were, I gave up smoking pot, and now I don't feel I'm the same, and I'm a little irritable. Okay, maybe you should start smoking again. This is an easy one. Go get yourself a dime bag. Have some fun. Answer that question in 2 seconds. Second question was, my husband of 30 years recently found out he had a child 2 months older than our youngest one. What do you think happened? I have to say to you, is this a real question? You have a couple of kids, so you know about the birds and the bees. What do you think happened? So I do a little reflective listening on this. And I would say, don't be stupid, you know what happened. Really, isn't that hard? Now the last question was, well, the marriage related. Does it work if only one person goes to marriage counseling? So I thought about this and I pondered. And my answer is as such. It all depends how good the bartender is. Just keeping it real, man. Now, listen. Go hug somebody you love. More importantly, tell them you love them. Because tomorrow's not guaranteed. My grandfather's still hanging in there. A lot of people still coming down with COVID. We don't want to lose any people. And if we do, we want to make sure they know how you feel. It was so good giving people hugs the other day and seeing them go out and give somebody a hug. Not random strangers. They probably lock you up for that. You'll be up there with Cuomo. You'll be with the Mario Defense Fund also. So listen, I'll talk to you next week. Have a great week. Cheers.